So your net worth. What is your net worth? And this is a very, very good question. And many of you may not see a reason to answer this question if you're at a certain position financially. But you should know. You should know at the end of every year at least what your net worth is standing at. And the reason that you should know this is because this gives you a picture of what your financial position is, where you are financially moving into the new year. And whether it's a good place or a bad place, it's still important to note. It's still important to understand where you are. So, what is your net worth? Well, your net worth is nothing more than what you own minus what you owe. And that is a very, very simple calculation. It's a very, very simple thing to understand, but then you go, okay, well, what do you mean what I own minus what I owe? What does that actually look like? Well, what you own is exactly that. Every single thing that you own, everything that you own, whether it be your car, your house, you know, whether it be investments that you have, the money in your bank account, all of those types of things are things that you own. And so that needs to be part of your net worth, obviously, because your net worth is doing nothing more than tracking how much you are worth. And that word net means that it is net of what you owe, right? And so it is what you are worth, meaning what you have, minus what you owe, right? It's, so we're saying net worth, right? Net of what you owe, how much are you worth? And so if we know that those things are the things that you own, then the things that you owe are pretty obvious as well, right? If you make a house payment, right, then the amount of money that you still owe on your house is how much you owe. If you make a car payment, then the amount of money that you still owe on your car is how much you owe. If you owe student loans, then the amount you owe on your student loans is how much you owe. If you owe credit card bills, then the amount that you owe on that credit card is how much you owe. And so you see, you end up with exactly what you would be worth if you took all of the things in the what you own column and you were to liquidate them, create cash, and pay off all the things you owe, and then you see what is left. Now, obviously, this is not a difficult calculation. Then you may say, well, Dylan, why do you spend this whole episode on this idea that is not too complicated, that is not too difficult? Well, because the net worth is what matters. And what do I mean? The net worth is what makes you a quote-unquote millionaire, right? When people say that they are millionaires, that does not mean, and this is a very, very common misconception, being a millionaire does not mean that you make $1 million in income or in salary or $1 million a year. That's not what that means. Being a millionaire means that you have a $1 million net worth. That means that you, if you take what you own and you subtract what you owe, then you will have $1 million left. Okay. And so that's what a millionaire is. And if our goal in building wealth is to get to that millionaire status, is to get to that point where we are financially free and we have a large amount of money saved up for ourselves, for retirement, for the future, things like that, then what we are shooting for is to have a high net worth. Because owning a lot of things is really, really useless if you own them and you owe a lot of money on them. So for instance, you can own your house, but the entire value of your house does not count towards your net worth. What counts towards your net worth is the amount of equity you have in your house. Because you got to think about it. What you own, yes, you own the house. So let's say it's a $250,000 house. Then you would put $250,000 on the own side. But if you owe $230,000 on that $250,000 house, then you would put that on the owe side. And so when you subtract that out, that is the equity in your home. So that $20,000 would actually go towards your net worth. And so you see that this is a very distinct calculation. And the same thing goes for something like your car. Let's say you're driving a car and the car's worth $14,000. And let's say you still owe $7,000 on that $14,000 car. Well, if that means you could sell it today for $14,000 and pay off the $7,000. So how much equity do you have in the car? You have $7,000. So that would go toward your net worth. And so you see where I'm going here. On all of these different things, that is what you would do. And for any of you out there that actually know accounting, then this is nothing different than the accounting equation. The basic accounting equation is assets equals liabilities plus equity. And so if you have assets, right, assets are what you own and liabilities are what you owe. And so if you just do a little quick algebra there, then assets minus liabilities equals equity. Or in other words, what you own minus what you owe equals what you are worth. And so in the personal finance sense, what you own minus what you owe is equal to your net worth. And so this is no different than a basic accounting equation.